Hey guys, and today is going to be a different kind of video. Me and my sister have been planning to do this for quite some time. We made plans to do these videos back in 2015, but we never actually got round to it. And my sister at the time was going through putting in her papers to go on a mission for our church. And the beginning of 2016 was quite hectic and busy, so we pushed it back a little. We knew exactly what we kind of wanted to do, but we hadn't got anything written in stone or written down on the actual topics. We had a few, but not some, they just weren't well planned. However, we felt together that this topic needed to be addressed through our channel, especially with what's happened recently. And my sister has allowed me to speak on behalf of the both of us for this video. So, growing up as a kid, I was a very confident young little girl. I was strong, I was happy, I was never really shy. I was in a world of my own, I guess. I loved my parents, I loved my family, I just loved life. Then I think when I reached junior school and then going into comprehensive school, so like high school for some of you guys, I started to get a little bullied. Everyone, I think at some point in your life you may have had a little teasing or a little knock there. I had my close friends, I loved my friends, and I became a little shy. I wasn't confident. I think for at least 5 years I wasn't confident. I was always shy, always kind of stuck to myself and my little group of friends. I wasn't basically the person you see now. And when I reached a high point in my life at the age of 16, I was much more confident. So this is during the time when I was at college. I was myself, I was outgoing, I loved my friends, I loved being around people, I loved being funny and just, you know, the kind of things that makes you you and socializing. Just when I had reached the peak and the highest moment of my life, that's when it all came crashing down and when I had my very first panic attack. I never really knew what anxiety or panic attacks were. I mean, I knew they existed, but I didn't know how it felt or what I was going through at the time. So I didn't know what I was feeling when I had my first couple of attacks. And so basically that's what I'm going to be talking about today. I suffer from anxiety and panic attacks, and it is not the best thing in the world. I don't want to put anyone down. This is just me and my sister speaking through this video as for awareness, I guess, and to let you guys know that I do deal with something in my personal life and I have gotten better over the years. In fact, I've come to a point in my life where I can actually handle panic attacks if they do occur, and anxiety especially I've gotten over a lot the last 3 years, and YouTube has definitely helped me with that. University also helped me with that. I wanted to talk about this because of what's happened very recently, which I will get into later. So for those of you who don't know, anxiety and panic attacks can come in very different forms. People are not always sure what a panic attack is or what they are feeling. I especially didn't know what I was going through the very first time I had a panic attack. And I didn't know what I was dealing with until the age of 19. So for your information, an anxiety attack basically is a person feeling fearful of something. They don't always know what that is, but it can be before they're gonna go out on stage or before they're gonna talk in front of lots of people, or even just going out in general. You just have this fear that something's gonna happen or something you're nervous about is going to affect you in some way. An anxiety attack may feel like your heart is racing, you feel stressed, you feel short of breath, and they are often normally short-lived as well, so they don't last long. Panic attacks, on the other hand, can be very different. You don't know exactly what you're fearing. It could be absolutely anything, and your mind kind of switches on and says, look, your body's in a bad situation, and your body goes into this process of protecting you. First off, you feel this kind of like really disturbing, hollow, warm feeling, and then it rises to your heart. It starts your heart racing really fast and it increases as the panic attack goes on. Your brain starts to think on so many different levels. Well, it can do, mine does. But sometimes you may feel like you're dying, like you're going to have a heart attack, or you're going to literally just collapse. I felt nausea and even dizziness when I go through a panic attack. I sometimes even like rub my hands together a lot, or rub my finger. I even sometimes touch my ear, my left ear especially. I sometimes have like a graze on my left ear from scratching it too much. Panic attack is something that's unprovoked, so it could come out of nowhere. There's not really any solid trigger. Some anxiety attacks are different. Anxiety attacks can be where you go to the same place, like a concert, or you go on a date, or you go somewhere that you've been before. And basically, if you've been in that situation before and you've had an attack, then when you go back to it, that attack could reoccur. It doesn't matter what time of day it is, it doesn't matter what time of year it is. It's just your brain kind of remembers the memory and then triggers your body to go into an anxiety attack. But a panic attack, however, can come literally out of nowhere. I've woken up some mornings where I literally have a panic attack and I have to stay in bed and wait until it's over. There was a time when I was walking to babysit some kids and I had an attack on the way and I just had to stop in the middle of the street. Thankfully, I had my sister there at the time and she helped me through it. And that's one thing I do recommend that's most important, is to have someone who knows what you're going through. Doesn't matter whether they've had a panic attack or an anxiety attack or not, just as long as they're aware how to be around you when you're going through that kind of an attack. There are people in my life that don't understand what anxiety and panic attacks are and how they affect that individual as well. Like, it is hard to understand, and it's not really something you can understand unless you've been through one. Panic attacks can last from 10 minutes to 25 minutes, depending on the length of the attack and how quickly it does go away. Sometimes you can help it, sometimes you can't. But it's not going to kill you, basically. It's not gonna last, it's not gonna be there forever. That's one of the things I think and tell myself as I'm going through one. I'm constantly saying, look, there's nothing wrong with you, you're completely fine, you're not gonna die, just breathe. And I eventually get through it. After an attack, you may feel fatigued, you may feel nausea, you may feel like you want to eat, but you don't at the same time. You may feel depressed. You may just feel like it's ruined your day and now you can't be happy, but I can tell you, you can be happy. You can pick yourself up from this. So I'm going to talk to you about my most rememberable panic attack. Because I didn't know what I was dealing with or going through the very first time I had an attack, it's really hard for me to remember which one was my first attack. But the one that's really rememberable was at a concert with my sister's best friend Bethan and my friend Courtney. Now, I've never fainted in my life, and I don't know why that is. I went to a Sleeping with Sirens concert, and during the the break between the two acts, I felt like I was going to faint. I thought that was what was happening to me. So I was standing with my two friends, and my heart started to race. And I felt like the room was coming in on me, and I felt like I couldn't breathe, and I was literally putting my head up so I could try and breathe in as much oxygen as I could. I'm not the tallest person, but I'm not the shortest either, so I'm kind of average height, and I was about level with everyone else next to me. So I was getting enough oxygen, at least what I thought, but I don't think my brain was thinking I was getting enough. My fingers started to tingle and I started to feel really like dizzy. And I turned to my friend Courtney, and she said she felt a little bit dizzy as well. So I turned to her and we basically tried to get out. Now, as I was walking out, my heart started to really, really race and I started to have a blackout. At this point, I thought, I've never experienced this in my entire life. I started to shake and I started to feel like I was going to die. I could hear a few things, but not everything. It was all started to get muffled and I didn't know what was going on. The sound of the voices in the room started to get much quieter. It was like I was being deafened by everything around me. And thankfully my friend Bethan was there and she took the bag that was on my back off. I thought someone was robbing me, so I tried to speak and some of my words were muffled and I couldn't really speak. But eventually she took my bag off, she got me some water, and I sat down and I had to take deep breaths, and I slowly started to get my vision back, very slowly. I started to tell myself, like, you're at a concert and everything's okay, you just need to breathe. So the reason panic attacks and anxiety attacks occur is because your body is, as I said, protecting itself. It's putting all those things into action that is trying to save your body when you're in a bad situation or when it feels like it's being threatened, even though you're not being threatened in any way, shape or form. Usually attacks start with sweating, cold sweats. You start to, like, your temperature starts to fluctuate in any direction. You can feel cold, you can feel hot and warm, and most of the time I get cold sweats when I start to panic, and then my hands start to shake. Nothing else really shakes, just my hands. You may start to then feel claustrophobic, or like the room's caving in, like you can't breathe, like you're choking. It's just all those kind of things at the same time. Sometimes it can even stop you from talking and make you sound weird, where you can't say specific words and you just sound like you're speaking a different language. You just feel like you can't control your body, and it scares you, and it would scare anyone if they're in that situation, especially if you're in a specific place and you cannot get out, like a concert, for instance, as I said, or even a date. I've had it when I've been on a date. I've had it when I've been on a train. That's why I'm quite fearful of traveling by train. Coaches and planes I'm fine, but trains I do have a fear of, because I've had a panic attack getting on and off a platform and on the train. It's just weird. So as I said, my anxiety attacks started at the age of 16. I didn't know what they were until the age of 19, and that's when I knew what I was going through but didn't know how to tell my friends or my family. Personally, I couldn't tell anyone until about the age of 22, when I finally told my sister. The thing with telling my sister was quite hard, because I am the older sister but I'm the middle child, and I just felt like as an older sister I should be a role model for my younger sister. I shouldn't be someone who has these problems, or I didn't feel like she thought I had these problems, and I just didn't want to seem like a failure. And I just felt for quite a few years that I couldn't tell her. I couldn't admit to her this thing that I'm going through. I didn't want to be someone who she's gonna have to be careful around, and I didn't want to be drawn attention to. And that's one of the reasons why I didn't tell my parents. But when I did finally tell her, I felt like a weight had just been lifted off my shoulders. She was completely fine with it. She was a bit cautious to begin with. I eventually did tell my parents in the same year, just towards the end of the year, because my sister said, you need our parents on support with you on this. Don't let that fear from telling them keep that away from you. You need to tell someone. If you suffer from anxiety or panic attacks, you do need to tell someone. When I started university is when I officially kind of knew what I was going through. And that came across when I did my first presentation at university. When I was walking to university, I had an anxiety attack. I was scared about what I was gonna be presenting in front of this class of people. Just before meeting my friends for this presentation, I had a panic attack. So anxiety attacks can turn into a panic attack, where you've calmed yourself down and then this attack just comes out of nowhere. I was stood at the bottom of the stairs outside my class at university and my hands started to go numb. I was like, how can I go into this presentation shaking like a leaf and feeling like I can't breathe? It was so hard. By the time my friends got to me, the panic attack had gone and I was okay. During the whole presentation, I was completely fine. I was still nervous, but that's just nerves. And after that, I felt so relieved that I had done it. Once you've done that thing that you've overcome, you feel a lot happier. And sometimes that can wipe away the memory of an attack in that same situation, because once I did a lot more presentations, my panic attacks started to disappear. I didn't have any during the time of when I did presentations at university, and I didn't get nervous that much. I still get nervous, I mean, it's speaking in public. After I had that attack at university, my outlook on life basically changed. I wanted to be a better person, I wanted to smile more, I wanted to make others feel like they're worth something. I wanted them to smile, and I just wanted to brighten up people's lives. I wanted them to feel happy, because I can't always feel happy all the time because I have these attacks. So I just wanted other people to feel happy because they don't suffer what I go through. Does that make any sense? I kind of hope it does. But I just wanted people to smile, and the lighting is going so dark. I forgot to have one of my lights on, so it's on now. So one of the main reasons why we as a channel wanted to put this video out there is because recently my sister emailed me and said that she suffers from anxiety and panic attacks as well. She didn't know this until she went on her mission. She didn't know how to tell me. She just wanted to know how to deal with it. And I said to her, look, don't feel like it means nothing, because it means everything. The fact that you have panic attacks and anxiety and you can talk to someone who has dealt with it and is still dealing with it is a good thing. She has given me the permission for this video to tell you exactly what happened in that situation. She wrote this personally to me. I asked her if I could share it in this video so you can understand what it's like to be on that side where, you know, your sister's been through it, myself, and now you've gone through an attack and you're not sure either what it is, but then you know your sister's gone through it. So if you know someone's gone through it, go talk to them, because you can share that kind of thing. And when she told me, I was half relieved that she knew what I was going through, but I would not wish this on her at all. And to know that she suffers from the same thing really got me upset. She goes, I will be honest, I was terrified the first time I had an attack. I had no clue what was happening, especially on a really fun day. I didn't want to tell my companion, and the other sisters had a teaching appointment. I crawled upon the couch and just cried. I tried to calm my breathing, wishing she could call me. The only person I wanted to talk to right then, but I knew I couldn't, so I did what I knew you would tell me to do. I breathed, and the attack didn't go all away at once, but I didn't feel alone anymore. And finally, after throwing up, I felt a lot better. I'm so grateful to have a sister that I can talk to about this. I don't believe mine are as bad as yours, but I just thought I'd tell you, it's really scaring me. So when my sister told me this, I wrote back to her and said, look, you're not going through this alone. You know I've been through it, and you should never feel like your attack means less than mine, or ever feel like yours are not worse than mine. They could be the same. Attacks affect people in many different ways. You should never feel like yours don't mean anything, because it is still an attack, it's still scary, and it still is something that needs to be known. It needs to be taken care of. You need to be taken care of. Even though you may feel like you're going to die, it is extremely rare that anyone can die from a panic attack. So seriously, don't worry about it. It's just don't let it get to you. I mean, it's a part of who you are, and I don't think you should ever judge a person on whether they're confident in real life or really shy in real life, because the most confident and the most intelligent people generally do get panic attacks and anxiety. They are often the ones that get it the most. I'm not saying that is the case, but that is what has been said. One thing that really does calm me down, especially before work, is doing my makeup. Makeup is a really nice relaxation, because I'm focused on creating a really good look for the day. And I also play music in the background. Sometimes I don't, just because I'm focusing too much and I don't want to be distracted. But I think what makes you comfortable and what makes you happy is most important when trying to get through the day and through what you think could start a panic attack. When going out, I do make excuses instead of telling people that I've just had a panic attack or I've just suffered through an experience based on anxiety. And I do make up the excuses that, yeah, I'm running late, or I had to do something, or I had to go back and get something. But the truth is, mentally, I'm not ready. One thing I did find out when I did admit that I had these attacks to my parents was that it can run in the family. There's some relation on my mum's side who does suffer from anxiety, and when I found that out, I was kind of relieved. Not in the sense that he had it, but in the sense that it just didn't... it wasn't only me, and it didn't come out of nowhere, because my sister didn't have it, my brother didn't have it, my dad and my mum didn't have it, but there was someone else in the family that did have it, and now unfortunately my sister suffers from it too. You may suffer from it, and then someone else you know may suffer from it later on, and you'll both be there for each other if you tell them. I think what's worse is when someone doesn't know what you're going through, and if you are that person who knows someone who's going through anxiety or panic attacks, please, please talk to them about it, research it, and just don't be the one who's smothering them or like constantly over them all the time, being cautious, because that can make it 10 times worse. And that has happened to me as well, where someone's been so like overprotective and it's made the situation worse. I think the best thing is just give them space, let them know that you're there for them, and just don't draw too much attention to the situation. I was at work the other day, and because my best friend knows I go through panic attacks, there was a customer that was really argumentative towards her, and I started to stand up for her and just kind of said, look, she can't go any faster than she's already going. You need to calm down and let her take her time with the way she's serving you. And he just literally just bit back at me and said, you don't know who I am, you don't know what I'm going through. And my hands under the desk were starting to shake, but the top half of me just looked normal. So even though he was very argumentative towards me, I was going through an anxiety attack with my hands under the desk shaking, and my heart was really, really racing. After he eventually left and I really sorted out the situation with the help of my supervisor, I had to bend down after that customer and really get myself together. My friend Katie, she just stood there and carried on serving and checked if I was okay, but didn't draw any attention to it or what I was going through. She knew I was having an attack, and I told her afterwards, and she said she knew what was happening. But it's just all about having someone who knows and knows how to deal with it by your side, because that's the most important thing when going through anything like that. One thing I did start to do when I was 16, I started to live by a motto, and I have always taught my sister this motto, and it's something that I live by, and it's now something that we can share together. And I've actually put it on our new YouTube banner, and it's basically be happy, be you. I have this written all over my letters. You may have seen it, me commenting to you on YouTube or Instagram or Twitter, and I normally end some of my comments and replies with that. I just think being happy is really important, and loving yourself is also important, but being you is what makes you. You can't be anyone else. I'm the only Katie. My sister's the only Claire, and it's not like there's going to be anyone else who is exactly like you and looks like you. You are you, and just live for you, be happy and be you. That's basically what I'm saying. I'm going to end the video there. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe to our channel, and feel free to comment in the section below. Any support, any experiences you've had, discuss what makes you feel happy, what helps you through panic and anxiety attacks, and just, you know, we're all here for you. We're a big family, the CrazyKinzies. We're a big family, and I love you guys so much. So, yeah. Bye guys. I am not going to get this video started. Okay.